Each year, 1 million tons of mushroom waste feedstock is generated in Europe. Funguschain project aims at the integral valorisation of agricultural residues from mushrooms, in particular from agaricus bisporus processing into bio-based functional additives and biopolymers using a cascading approach and demonstrating its industrial viability by building a new biorefinery and modifying industrial current lines.
For every mushroom that is harvested, a section of the mushroom the stove has left behind, and the Funguschain program has investigated how we can apply a clean process to create higher value products from the stove.
The Funguschain concept is a biorefinery model that consists of different phases. Some operate in cascade and others in parallel, depending on the intermediate product to be extracted.
I'm standing here beside the washing line, which is an element of our powder production facility. And here we take the stalk and convert it into a protein-rich food ingredient. This then has been used by the Funguschain members to create further high-value products for application to food, nutrition, bioplastics, and indeed cosmetics.
This facility can currently process 400 to 600 kilograms per day and is currently in the process of increasing this capacity to 1,200 kilograms per day. The upscaled biorefinery facility is divided in a pre-processing facility and a further cascade module to enable the cold water extraction to obtain proteins, sugars, and flavor components. Different technologies have been also demonstrated as part of the cascade model. The UA team has developed and validated methods based on microwave-assisted extraction for the efficient fractionation of polyphenols and lipids. KTH Royal Institute of Technology has developed and optimized pressurized hot water extraction of soluble polysaccharides, mainly alpha and beta glucans, from mushroom cutoffs. It has optimized the process for the saccharification of the insoluble mushroom biomass into fermentable sugars as well. Extracted sugars were assessed and upscaled at BioTrend as carbon source in the production of biopolyesters through fed batch fermentation processes. Thanks to these processes, several products have been obtained in the Funguschain biorefinery. In turn, they can be used for different industrial applications.
We have identified possible markets and in particular three different value chains.
In the food value chain, the fraction containing proteins extracted from the mushroom waste has been used by Biozoon in order to obtain novel food paste and drinks for elderly nourishment.
Indeed, the protein extracted not only have a unique humanities, but they can help putting a texture to help people with swallowing difficulties.
In the cosmetic market, one of the key drivers is the preference of the consumers and brand owners towards sustainable products. Following that approach, two cascade products containing chitin glucan and polyphenol lipid fractions were assessed by Saponia for this value chain. Finally, only chitin glucan was incorporated in three different types of products: emulsion, oil, and soap bars of natural origin as a substitute for chemical antioxidants that are not acceptable in natural cosmetics. The test performed guided us regarding tentative quantities required to achieve same efficacy without compromising the quality of the final product. In the bioplastic value chain, in which several partners have been involved, Condensia has developed a series of additives and biolubricants for polymers coming from the lipids obtained from mushroom waste. Those additives have been included in novel bioplastic formulations carried out by Technaro and Novomont. These formulations are a combination of several biopolymer building blocks that includes PLA from total corbium and other polysaccharides, which are basically formed by glucans and fermentable sugars that were valoroids into novel bioplastic grades. Myplast, with the support of ATIP, has used blown film extrusion process for the production of films with the bioplastics previously produced. Different products have been validated with these films: thin and thick bags for food, and biodegradable in soil mulch films. A circular solution that comes from agriculture and for food and agriculture. The final stage of the cascade process was to assess its potential as biogas. This has been carried out by OWS. The material was chemically analyzed for dry and organic matter and nitrogen content, and the biogas potential was determined in a biological batch test. In parallel with the cascading process, ECNP and BDS have performed transversal and necessary activities dealing with life cycle and safety assessments, respectively.
It was an ambitious project with the aim to use at least 40% of the mushroom waste, leading to at least 3 novel products.
These studies allowed us to obtain a framework over the environmental and health potential impact and effects of a wide range of extracted products. Moreover, BDS, using a specific cell-based assays and advanced chemical analytics, identified compounds that modulate the activity of receptors involved in fat metabolism, which could partly explain the mushroom's health effects. The aim is to apply this knowledge to develop future high-value products that help to combat obesity and metabolic syndrome. Likewise, good results came out at demo scale using glucan-rich extracts. There are some colored antioxidant components in them, which might be used as a substitute for fossil-based antioxidants and carbon black in mulch films.
Funguschain program has investigated how we can apply clean process to create higher value products from the stock.
4 years later, we met our aims. The factory is there. The products are there.
And this represents a circular bioeconomy case study where the mushroom waste becomes an exploitable resource.
Funguschain is a clear example of how circular bioeconomy becomes a reality. The valorization of the residues represents a step forward towards the synthesis of valuable chemicals and materials to be further used in key sectors in the European economy.